बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ दैट आई एम मिस नौशीन नसीर, योर इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट टीचर। आई होप यू विल बी फाइन। ओके, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेसन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल रीड यूनिट नंबर 3, द हनी गाइड्स रिवेंज, फ्रॉम योर कोर्स बुक पेज नंबर 36 to 38। It is a story taken from the Zulu tradition. The Zulu tribe is spread across the country of South Africa. Now start the story. This is the story of Negede the honey guide and a greedy young man named Gingele. One day while Gingele was out hunting, he heard the call of Negede. Gingele's mouth began to water at the thought of honey. He stopped and listened carefully, searching until he saw the bird in the branches above his head, chittick, chittick, chittick. The little bird first called out to Gingele to get his attention and then flew ahead, making sure the Gingele was following him. When he reached a huge fig tree, he hopped around and then settled on one branch, cocking his head to guide Gingele. Gingele couldn't see any bees from under the tree, but he trusted Negede. So Gingele put down his hunting spear under the tree, gathered some dry twigs and made a small fire. When the fire was burning well, he put a long dry stick into the heart of the fire. He began climbing, holding the cool end of the smoking stick in his teeth. Soon he could hear the loud buzzing of the busy bees. When Gingele reached the hive, he pushed the smoking end of the stick into the hollow. The bees came rushing out angrily and giving Gingele some painful stings. When the bees were out, Gingele pushed his hands into the nest. He took out handfuls of the heavy comb, dripping with rich honey. He put the comb carefully in the pouch he carried on his shoulder and started to climb down the tree. Finally, Gingele reached the bottom of the tree. Negede flew down and waited for a fat piece of honeycomb as his reward. But Gingele put out the fire, picked up his tools and started walking home. Ignoring the bird, Negede called out angrily. So Gingele stopped and said, "The bird, you want some honey? Although I did all the work and got all the stings, why should I share this honey?" Then he walked off. Negede was furious and decided to get his revenge. Several weeks later, Gingele again heard the honey call of Negede, remembering the last time, and followed the bird once again. Negede came to rest in a great thorn tree. Gingele thought the hive must be in this tree. He quickly made his small fire and began to climb the smoking branch in his teeth. Negede sat and watched. He pulled himself up another branch, but instead of the hive, he found himself face to face with the leopard. Angry at being disturbed, the leopard struck at Gingele. Gingele rushed down the tree and ran fastly with injuries. Honey guide had his revenge and Gingele learned his lesson. And so when the children of Gingele hear the story of Negede, they learned lesson. Whenever they harvest honey, they make sure to leave the biggest part of the comb for honey guide. So students, I hope you enjoyed the story, and I think this story gave us the lesson of kindness and sharing. Now there is a worksheet for you. In this worksheet, you will do write meanings of the difficult words from the course book page number 36-37 in notebook and make sentences by using these words. Also do learn to read 1 question 2-3 on page 39 in course book. Learn to read 1 question number 1, 4 and 5 on page 39. And learn to read 2 question number 1 on page number 39 in notebook from unit 3, the honey guide's revenge.